chilling image was played repeatedly on television, a man with a long beard flogging a woman. The two-minute video was purportedly shot in the Swat Valley when the Taliban controlled the territory. Although its authenticity has been challenged, to the Pakistani public, it underscored the group's extreme form of Islam. In the 2 months since, there have been a series of bombings. Saturday, thousands mourned the death of a prominent critic of the Taliban. The Muslim cleric was killed in a suicide bombing on his mosque. Many officials and experts see the bombings and the flogging video as a tipping point. While no scientific polls have been released, there have been repeated examples of public opinion turning against the Taliban. Harlan Ullman is a South Asia expert at the Atlantic Council in Washington.
You now have clerics, the ulama, standing up and saying, this is against the Quran. I would hope the Pakistani government will be able to say that Taliban and extremists, one, are not Muslims and are not Pakistanis. Delegitimize them. Get the word out. Now is the time to mobilize the public.
Shuja Nawaz, also of the Atlantic Council, says the challenge to the Taliban should come from across the political spectrum.
To be able to point out to them that the Islam that they talk about is a convoluted view. It is not Islam as the people of Pakistan know it or want it to be.
Others say the Pakistani public appears still deeply conflicted over how its government is dealing with threats from the Taliban. Since military action began in the Swat Valley, the number displaced by fighting has grown to 2.5 million. Most live in camps. Nawaz says the government should seize the moment and quickly provide relief and rebuild Swat communities.
If it is not proactive, this sentiment could turn against the government and create a further problem, and that's the challenge.
After the Pakistani earthquake in 2005, U.S. military personnel delivered relief supplies to victims. While the United States says it has provided nearly $165 million in assistance to people affected by the fighting, the Pakistani government has limited the reach of U.S. soldiers. Jonah Blank, an advisor to the U.S. Senate Foreign Relations Committee chairman, says Pakistan's approach is wrong.
No U.S. Military personnel have been allowed to bring either supplies or surgical hospital or other assets that the U.S. military is very well equipped to deliver to the people who need it.
Obama administration officials propose tripling the size of non-military assistance to Pakistan. But Blank says in building a long-term relationship, the U.S. should also listen to Pakistan's concerns.
Whether it is about Abu Ghraib or about Gitmo or about the Predator program or about U.S. policy in other parts of the world, we can't simply dismiss these concerns as irrelevant to the core discussion.
Experts say with the U.S. providing assistance at a time when opinion has turned against the Taliban, America's image among Pakistanis will improve as it did after the timely relief to earthquake victims. Ravi Khanna, VOA News, Washington.